In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. That's a lovely day, Fairfield. This is the ministry of Thy Word is Truth from Rivers of Living Water, Pastor Susie Andrew. Today, I just wanted to talk to you about the most important topic for every human being existing on this planet Earth. Who is God, Charlie? Who is He? We're going to speak about Him today. Who is God? And why we're doing this? Because the rapture is very soon, and that's the next event that we are waiting, not the wars, because the wars are erupting everywhere, you know, even with Zelensky, whatever his name, and going with the other Korean, and this is overwhelming, and Egypt with the other African, very overwhelming, add more wars. But it's important to know who is God, because if you don't know Him and He don't know you, you're not in a good place, Charlie. Who is God? Simple. And the Bible is telling us that God is love, of course. It's the abundant love that exists. So if your heart is empty and you're sad and you're lonely and you're not happy because you don't have the love of God, it's only the love of God who can make you happy for no reason. You could facing trials, but happy because He is love. He fills you with the love, an abundant and extremely love. But the thing here, the love wanted to express itself. You cannot love yourself, otherwise you'd be called selfish.
I'm not loving myself. I'm
yeah,
loving
and
you.
God, yeah. And me too, Charlize. That's on the recorder now. My husband will hear this. All right. Yeah. Right. So the love that God is has to be expressed, because His nature is love. So we have grace and mercy. Grace is the love part of God, and the mercy is how He showed that love to us. It's the action, loving action called mercy. He come, and because we don't merit anything, He pour His love over the humankind. But God tried to show up, you know, in the beginning, before all the religion started. And guess what? People, instead of being happy to see God and talk to Him and that true love coming to visit them, they were so scared. They trembled. There is a nation called Israel, if you don't know them. One nation at one time, in a minute of time, at all the eternity, never happened before. A nation saw God with their own eyes, and they heard Him speaking on the Mount Sinai in Egypt. So that's a big event, is in Egypt, Mount Sinai. And the mountain was trembling. And God said to Moses, you know, make the people ready. For 3 days, they were ready, washing and cleaning and waiting to see God and talk to Him face to face. Can you imagine? There is a nation, that's why Israel is a bit specific, different from all other nations. They had the revelation on a human format. They saw the eyes of God and they lived.
Is it?
Yeah.
Nobody listening to me.
You are listening to
only,
me, and that's more than
me.
I have a lot of people listening, Charlie. Don't
nobody,
you worry.
Only me.
No. There
and
is...
He's sitting, but he
but this
know.
Is on the recording.
No, no, one word.
All right. Well, let's see in English, then turn in Arabic. Naharda nikalim ala Allah. Min huwa Allah?
I don't know.
Allah, so you sit in the Arabic version then.
Don't speak Arabic. I don't want
to. Allah huwa al-mahabba al-mutlaqa. ومن غير المحبة دي ما فيش حاجة. فلو أنت مش سعيد ولا فرحان في حياتك، ولو في I just want to make sure yeah connection do connection Lord and so that البلد الولد الوح... الله في محبته لازم يظهرها، وإلا يبقى إله أناني. فالله لما بين محبته بنقول عليها في نعمة وفي جريس اند ميرسي والرحمة. الرحمة ان هو عمل انت بتشوف فيه رحمته عليك ومحبته ليك. وبدل ما تقول انا وقعت واتخبطت وتعورت، تقول اشكرك يا رب انا ما كسرتش رجلي ولا اي حاجة. امبارح احفادي الاثنين جايين متعورين في ركبهم، وزعلان واحد منهم قوي انه اتعور. فبقول له بدل كده اشكره انه رجلك ما اتكسرتش. So this is in English. You know, my two grandson came with a knee. You know, yesterday they fall on their knee, and one of them was very unhappy. And I said to him, instead of being unhappy that you're not that you're wounded, thank God that you are not a broken bone. So that's the mercy of God. We're talking about the mercy. So the love in action is the mercy of God. Love alone is the grace that you don't deserve this, and He's giving it to you. So Allah ظهر لشعب معين. الشعب ده هو شعب إسرائيل في أرض مصر على جبل صهيون, ماونت ساين, ماونت سوري ماونت سيناي, في جبل سيناء, على جبل سيناء في مصر. الله ظهر للأمة بحالها, أمة بحالها شافت الله بعينيها وسمعت صوته. قال لها, قال لهم يتقدسوا قبلها 3 أيام وما فيش حيوان يقرب من الجبل وإلا هينصعق. والله نزل بجلاله على الجبل, مش جبل صهيون, جبل سيناء في مصر. واليهود شافوه بعينيهم, شافوا جماله وترعبوا. فانت النهارده اللي بتلسن على ربنا لو شفته هتترعب. ربنا كان عايز يقرب من شعبه ويعرفهم ويعرفوه, لكن الحقيقه هم خافوا منه. قالوا موسى, لا 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 يا عم, انت روح قابله اتكلم معاه شوف هو عايز ايه, وبعدين تعالى قول لنا واللي هو هيقوله احنا هنعمله. ده اللي عملوه اليهود, وده اللي عملوه ناس كتير مننا. يقول لك انت, انا اروح اصلي لفلان وفلان يكلم ربنا عني. طب ليه انت ما تكلموش بنفسك؟ لا 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 يا عم خليني بعيد عنه, لانك انت فاكر انه الله جبار ومجرم صعب عايز يموتك. لكن هو الله, مين هو الله النهارده؟ الله محبة, الله محبة. So you are scared of God like the Israelites. They were so scared of God and said to Moses, you go and talk to him and whatever he wants, we will be doing. And I see that like many Christians even doing that, instead of talking straight to God, they find someone intermediate and they talk to them and ask whatever they want. They can't talk to God because they're scared of him. But today the message is God is love. And the love in a format that you and I can see. So God was thinking again, if they are so scared of me. And in the book of Corinthians his 2 is saying, what eyes have not seen and what ear have not heard, what God is preparing for those who fear him or those who love him. ما لم تره عين ولم يخطر على ولم تره عين ولم تسمع به أذن ولم يخطر على بال بشر ما أعده الله الذين يحبونه. So those who loved him. فالله أعد حاجات جميلة جدا ليك وليا. God prepare wonderful things that your eyes have never seen and your ears never heard and your mind never even think of, that prepared from that love to come and reach you for those who love him. The problem is today, the people who fear God, like, oh, no, 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 don't come to us. We're going to talk to the priest or to the pastor or to the saint, whatever. They will never have an access, an encounter with that real love, God. But he prepared things that we never think that can exist. Our eyes cannot see. Our ears never heard. And our imagination, put imagination as much as you want into the kind of happiness that you desire. And that's even beyond that is God. يعني انت لو حطيت تخيلك في اوسع ما تخيلك واكتر ما تتمناه عينك او تتمنى تسمعه, الله يكون اكتر من كل ده. هو اعده للذين يحبونه. ربنا قال انا هجرب طريقه تانية, طالما هم مش قادرين يتواجهوا معايا ويقابلوا محبتي جهاد وانا صعب عليهم كده, الجبل بقى يترعش ونار نزلت. تصور انت لو نار تنزل وسطنا دلوقتي, مين هيقوم يحارب اخوه؟ Imagine that God will fall on that time on the Mount of Sinai as a fire. He fall among us and the trembling of the people and the mountain was shaking like an earthquake. And who wanted to go and meet God face to face and be in front of him? I bet you no one will dare to kill another man or another woman. They will be so scared of that love. But because the love of God is not into their hearts, they dare to hurt his creation. But God said, okay, let me write for them with my hand a recipe for them to be happy. I want them happy. If you ask any man and woman today, what would you like to have or to be? They said, I want to be happy. So God creates, you know, two stones and he writes with his own hands on them how to be happy. He put the formula of the happiness of man. So ربنا الله قال أنا عايز أنا عايزهم أنا بحبهم وهم مش قادرين يجوا في حضوري because خافوا وترعبوا أولادي صغيرين وخافوا. امبارح الحفيد الصغير بتاعي جده بيكلمه بصوت عالي اتخض وعيط. قلت له خليك رقيق معاه. So my little grandson, you know, his grandfather was talking to him and he was a bit loud and he started crying and I said to him, be gentle. So God tried to be gentle with us. Because when we saw him on the mountain and the mountain trembled and people trembled too, they couldn't face that beauty and that complete love. They couldn't. They said, Moses, you take that burden. See him and what he wants, we will do. So God said, okay, I write the recipe on two tablets of stones. The happiness recipe of humankind, I write it down on the stone. And the Christians say, oh, God is annulled the law. Well, this is the first thing that he give it in writing. So Christians are misinterpreting the verse because they don't understand the Old Testament. They don't know that every promise and everything is in the old and revealed in the new. Without the old, you can't understand the new. Poor Christian, they're very limited. They limit God. Yeah, they are both Christian. There is one God, darling. We're talking about him today. Who is God? That's our preaching today. Who is he? Because I'm pretty sure if you know him, you will love him the way that he loves you. Problem is like you're confused. Who is God? Is he that religion? Or he is never religion. God is love and he show his love in a format. And he give us the Ten Commandments on the law, the recipe which make us happy. So if you stop envying, you know, the wife of your neighbor, you'll be really, and the car and the beautiful mansion of your neighbor, you're really doing good to yourself. So if you're seeing it the way that God put it, in a format of love to save you, and if you connect to him and him alone, instead of using his name as a swear word, that the flow of love will come upon you and that cannot contain your heart as to overflow. And find some human to express your love to him. So, لما الله شاف ان الشعب مش قادر يحتمل حضوره وابتدوا يترعشوا قال انا هديهم قالوا له قول لنا راح كتب لهم على حجر بصباع ربنا اصبع الله كتبت على الحجر عشان ما حدش يقول ايه اول مره الله يدينا حاجه المسيحيين بيقولوا ايه ان خلاص احنا مش تحت الناموس احنا مش تحت بجهاله بيكوز هم ما فهموش العهد القديم. كل حاجة في العهد القديم هي المواعيد والقصة بتاعتنا الأولانية تفسيرها والفك بتاع رموزها في العهد الجديد. فلو أنت بتقرأ العهد الجديد بس ما تقراش القديم أنت مش فاهم حاجة. عايز تطلع تخش الامتحان وأنت مش فاهم حاجة. فالكتاب المقدس اتكتب أول واحد اتكتب بأصبع الله الريسيبي اللي هي الوصفة بتاعة السعادة اللي هو عايز الإنسان يبقى سعيد بيها. مش قوانين عشان تعذبه. يعني انت لو بطلت تشتهي امرأة قريبك وعربيته وبيته وكل الحاجات اللي عنده انت بترحم نفسك من حاجات كتير. هيبقى عندك سعادة لانك هتبقى مقتنع بالعطاه لك الله. لو حبيته من كل قلبك زي ما هو قال وما بقتش تستخدم اسمه كأنك تشتم بيه وتلعن بيه والكلام ده اللي بيعملوه كل كلمة والتانية جيزس يحطوها ويسوير عليه اسم الله بالباطل هتلاقي محبة مالت قلبك بدرجة انك انت ماشي في كل حتة عايز تلاقي حد توري له محبة حقيقية بتاعت الله. فربنا كتب لنا الوصفة بتاعت سعادة بني البشر كتبها في كتاب او كتبها على حجرين لوحين وعطاهم لموسى. موسى طبعا انا خليني اقول لك كده هو تاني هو بيقول لك God's greatest love letter كتب قصة طويلة رسالة طويلة لبني البشر وكتبها كتبها بإيدين بشر علشان نبقى شاهدين على نفسنا عشان الأولى دي ما استحملناهاش برضو، أصبع الله كانت قوية جدا. موسى ما قدرش يستحمل الخطية في حضور أصبع الله، لأن أصبع الله فيها دينونة، فالكسر اللوحتين كسروا منه. وربنا قال أنا هكتب كلمتي، هكتب رسالة الحب بتاعتي على ورقي، أو يكتبوها هما وتتكتب على شاهد فم 2 أو 3، لما يسمعوا كلامي هيعرفوني، لما يعرفوني هيحبوني أو هياخدوا المحبة اللي عندي دي. عندي محبة كتيرة قوي عايزة أوزعها على أولادي وأحبابي. قابلت ست دلوقتي في سوق الخضار، بقول لها بنتكلم عن خضار ده إيه وده إيه، وبعدين بقول لها معاكي أحفاد، قالت لي 30. يا سلام، ده أنتي شاطرة قوي، عندها قدرة تحب 30 أحفيد ليها. الله عنده أحفاد كتير ويقدر يحبهم كلهم، ويحبهم محبة أبدية، حبهم قبل ما يجيبهم وحبهم بعد ما جابهم، وما زال لسه بيحبهم. فالله حاول يتراءى وسط الناس، وكل واحد خاف منه وبعد عنه. وبعدين قال لا 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 لا، أنا لازم أجي بنفسي وأخليهم يختبروني وأقلل مجدي عشان يقدروا يشوفوه. So God, when he moved among people and they were so scared of him, he said, no, 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 that's not very good. I'm gonna reduce my glory. I'm gonna shrink my love for them and put them in a human format so that when they experience that real love, they may understand me. And you shall call his name Jesus. That's the word of the angel. And Jesus was born as God into the flesh. Because we couldn't contain God into the natural. He's too soul, force, power, love uncontainable. You cannot contain him. He probably scare you because you're going to focus on who you are and what you do. And I call his name Jesus. And he came and he redeemed. He redeemed the humankind, died for them so they can have eternal life. You have heard that many times. And the word of God say, when we are still sinners, Christ died for us. لو احنا بعد خطاه مات المسيح من اجلنا. And he gave us خلاص ابدي. So the living in God's love and God's grace, this is the message of today. Well, you can grace when you feel like you're forgiven, you're clean. You don't focus on you, but you focus on him and the way that he loved you. An offering of God for forgiveness is offering a new life, and this life is eternal. Because without sin, the verse saying, شعب مغفور الاسم, مش هيكون بينهم مرض. ايه الآية الجميلة دي؟ ولا يقول أحد أنا مرضت، لأن الشعب ساكن فيها مغفور الاسم. لكن الآية دي في العهد القديم ربطت بين أمراضك وبين خطاياك. ولا يقول الساكن فيها أنا مرضت، لأن الشعب الساكن فيها مغفور الاسم. أما المسيح غفر خطايانا، مفيش لا مرض ولا أذية ولا حرب ولا كراهية ولا الحاجات دي ولا حقد ولا غيرة يقدر يخش في قلوبنا، لأنك أنت هتبقى قاعد في النعمة بتاع الخطية المغفورة. And in that Bible verse, I hope I say it in English well, that these people will say that I cannot be sick because these people living in this place, their sins is forgiven or are forgiven. So when you have sins forgiven, you cannot be sick. You cannot. You cannot have a nightmare. You cannot have depression. You live into the realm of the love of God and his forgiveness. And the thing is, when Jesus offered his hand to save you and give you that eternal love and eternal life, he wants you to extend your hand to another people to show them the love that he has. And when Jesus came in the flesh, we think, oh, he came only I was asking a pastor, why do you think Jesus came? And he said, to forgive our sin. I said, what other reason? Is this the only reason why he created us without sin? Why all this story? because we couldn't comprehend God, we couldn't understand him. So he diminished himself and his glory to be in a format that you and I can comprehend, human like us, feel like us, and give us all those bonds that we enjoy, marriage and children and family and grandchildren. So with all those bonds and friendship, all this amount of format of love that we experience, then we can make be having the taste of God. You know what? He is the goodness. There is no goodness outside him. I assure you, there is no goodness. There is no joy outside. And if it's outside joy, it's not the real thing. And Jesus, when he came, everyone wants to ask him question about God, about heaven, about what should we be doing, you know, the word of God, come and walk among us. He is the word of God, taking a format of a flesh. So they were running after him to ask him question about the word of God. Explain to us, Moses said, what would you say? So another reason why Jesus came, to show the glory of the Father in a format that we can embrace. Like if we have here an atomic reactor with the atomic power, no one can stand the atomic power. We're all gonna bursting and melting inside. That's the power of God, of course, and much more. But he took a smaller format like the lamp. That's why he said, I'm the light of the world. You know, he can be the light of the world as hard as the sun, as the atomic power and energy. Or he can be that atomic love, that love within your hearts, who can change you and bring tears to your ears, to your eyes. Sorry. I just want to ask you today, when the last time you cried with tears? You see the baby, you know, he wants something, he cried with tears, easy. How about you? When was the last time you cried in tears? When was the last time your heart was moved? If you all time cry, as you said, then the love of God is in your heart. But if you're hard on your heart and you cannot really feel anything, that God departed and go to someone else and somewhere. So Jesus is everything you really need. And he wrote it into that love letter, which is the Bible. Pastor Alfie, come, because otherwise... He multiplied, he fed them, he gave them the water, exactly as the Father was doing in the wilderness. He came and showed exactly all the works of the Father in a simple format. يسوع جه وحط كل الحاجات اللي كان بيعملها الله الآب في الفورمات بتاعت بني أدمين عشان نقدر نستحملها. لأن هو طاقة ملهاش حدود، قوة ملهاش نهاية. لو اتواجد في وسطنا حقيقي دلوقتي كلنا نسيح وإحنا قاعدين عظمنا ولحمنا يسيح زي ما الكتاب المقدس بيقول. لكن هو حد مجده صغر القدرات بتاعته الامكانيات بتاعته عشان يبقى على حدودك وحدودي، وعلشان يجي يفهمنا كلمة الله اللي احنا رفضناها وما مشيناش فيها كبشر. أكلنا أطعمنا علمنا ازاي نصلي، because هو جاي وجاي قريب، بس المستعدين والمنتظرين هم اللي هيجوا يكونوا معاه. And because Jesus is coming and he's coming soon. And if you're not be ready at watching, you're gonna miss the greatest event that humanity are waiting for. We're not waiting for another war or the Antichrist. Christ has to come first. For you, are you watching for that event, knowing that he's gonna change your nature to be like him? And you have a crown. So here is, I don't know if you see my picture, you don't, but the one who are with me on the internet, see that love for this woman. When the love of God come and enter into your inner being and in yourselves, you're totally different person. You see some people and they are gentle, they're nice, they're happy, even with their lack of richness, whatever. Go and see this picture, Pastor Alfie. Come see this beautiful old lady. When she's touched by the love of God. I wish I was able to draw. The love of God changed, brother and sister. And then you feel his presence with you. Every obstacle you have, you know, like you've been sick and, oh, I've been sick. No, you're healed. Praise God, I'm healed. ما تفرحيش في عدوتي لأني إن سقطت أقوم، تشكره لأنك خفيت، مش تزعل إنك كنت عيان. الشعب الساكن فيها مغفور الاسم، يقول لا أنا، هذا الشعب يقول لا يقول إن أنا مرضت. The people who are living into this city say we can't say that we are sick because our sins are forgiven. So today, and I'm finishing with this, God is looking from up high and see upon the children of man to see if there is any that understands, anyone who's seeking God. من السماء، الله من السماء أشرف على بني البصر لينظر، بص على البني آدمين عشان يشوف إيه، هل من فاهم طالب الله؟ هل من فاهم طالب الله؟ هل أنت عندك الإدراك إن كل حاجة أنت عايزها هي فيه ومش في حد تاني؟ إيه اللي أنت عايزه النهاردة؟ إيه اللي أنت بتتمناه النهاردة؟ علشان كده يسوع اسمه I am. The great I am. أنا هو. أنا هو. كل حاجة أنت بتتمناها واحتاجها وأنت عاوزها هي فيه هو. أبانا أنا بصلي إن كلمتك توصل لقلوب الناس واللي لسه ما يعرفكش يعرفك، بيكوز هم مش عارفين إن كل احتياجهم هو فيك أنت، وإن هم عايزين يحبوك لكن مش عارفين. فسافحهم على الجهل بتاعهم وتعالى اعلن نفسك ليهم مرة تانية. في اسم المسيح الغالي أمين. Just pray, Father, that you are revealing yourself to the people. They don't know who you are, and they don't know how to love you. But today, reach out to them one more time, Father, and let them know your love so they love you back. I pray that into the name of Jesus.